In this video, we will discuss concept of joins. We are having the three main capabilities of select statement: selection, projection, and joins. We already discussed the selection and projections. Today we will discuss concept of joins. Whenever we have to obtain the data from multiple tables, we have to use the concept of joins. How? Like, we are having one employee table, second one is a department table. In employee table, we are having the employee ID, first name, last name, hire date, and other columns, like in department ID. While in department tables, we are having the department ID, department name. If we want to display the name of employee and the department name of the employee, department name value is available in department table, while name values are stored in the employees table. So for that one, to retrieve the data from more than one table, we have to use the join. For joins, we are having the different types of the joins. First one, we are having the natural join. In natural join clause, natural join, we are having the three different clauses are there: natural join clause, using clause, and on clause. Then we are having outer joins, and then we are having the cross joins. In outer joins, we are having the left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. First one, we are having the concept of natural join clause. What we have in natural join clause, we are having the two different table, employee table and department table. It automatically, our department table and location table, it identify the common column among both of these table. Let select and department employees table, we are having the employee ID, first name, last name, job ID, and department ID. Table is here from employees. If we select it and execute this one query, we will see here employee ID 100, name is Steven, department ID is 90. Next one is also 90. Here we are having Alexander and department ID 60. So what is the department name of department ID 90, department ID 60, department ID 100? So for that one, we are having another query: select and department table, department ID and department name from departments. When we execute this one query, see that department ID 10 administration, we have to find it over at department ID 60, that is IT, and department ID 90, we are having the executive. So if we want to find what is the department name of Steven, so that is executive, Nena, that is executive, and for this one Alexander, department name is IT. Why? Because the department ID is 60. So department ID 60, department name is IT. What we have to do? We have to apply the joins to retrieve the data from more than one table. What will be happen? It in natural join clause, it will identify the common column. Natural join clause identify the natural join clause identify the common column whenever we are having the concept of the common columns, if we are having one common columns, so it will create the join based on that one column. If we are having more than one column that are common in two different tables, then join will be created based on those columns. If we are having this, both of those common column are having, in whenever common column are the common, column names are same in two different tables. If they have the different data type, then it will display the error message. So how we can use the natural join clause? So to use the natural join clause, we have to use the select few columns from the employees table that we are having from employees. I am using the employee first name, last name, job ID, department ID, and then department names. Table is here from employees, natural join department. So we have to use, we are using the few columns from employee table, first name, last name, job ID, let, these are from the employee table. Department ID and department name are from the department tables. From employee tables, I want to use it over here, alias E, and for department table I am using the alias D. Now we said it, we have to use it over here, the name of the table dot column names, that E dot, it is used to display that employee table, and we are having E is used to represent the employee table, and first name is the column of employee table. Same for the E dot last name, employee table column, that is the last name, E dot job ID, E dot department ID, and now here we are using the department ID. Join will be created based on the department ID column. So the column that is used for joining among two different tables. So in natural join clause, we can't use the table name with that one table, because department ID is available in employee table as well as department table. If we use it, it will display the error message. First we executed this one query, and it will create join among two different tables. We create the join. It takes data, first name, last name, job ID from employee table, department ID and department name from the department tables. What I say that never use in natural join clause the table name dot column names, the for the those column who are used in join, in natural join clause. Just execute this one, it will display the error message that we are having the column used in natural joins cannot have a qualifiers. The column that is used in natural join, we can't use the table name with that column. So never use it. We can apply the same practice for any other table. Let we are having the another table, employee table and department table and location table. Let we are having the department name. Then we are having the another, this one is from the department table, city is from the location table, and we are having the street address. In both of these table, department table and location table, join is performed based on the location ID from departments D. Natural join locations L. Now we can use it over here, D dot department ID, D dot city ID, and L dot street address. Now city is from the location table, so use it over here, L dot city. Execute it. It takes data from the two different table, department table and location table. Now, if we want to create a join using the natural join clause among the three different tables, like employee, department and location, or we can create a join, let few queries that we want to use the table as, select first name, last name, job ID, then we are having the department ID, next one department name, location ID, then city, postal code and street address. Table is here from employees. For column table alias we are using E. Natural join. Departments. D. And then again natural join. We have to create the natural join among first employee with the department and department with the locations, as we can't directly create the join among the employee and location. Reason is that there is no common column between employee and location. Natural join locations, and for locations we have to use the L. So what we have, E dot first name, E dot last name, employee dot job ID, department ID, this one column is used in the natural join clause, so we can't use the qualifier with such column. Department name is from the department table, D dot department name. Location ID again is used to join among the table departments and locations, so never use it in natural join clause, remember that. L dot, then postal code, L dot postal code, that belong to the location table, L dot street address. Now select this one and execute it. Now it takes the data from the three different table and display the record. That if you want to use it over here, any other, like we said it, just display the all of those implies first name, last name and city names of all of those employees whose city name is Oxford. How? Let me say select first name, last name and city. Table is there from employees, E, natural join. Now we can't directly, here we are taking the column of the department table, employee table and locations table, but we may not be able to directly create join between employee table and location table. Reason is that one, there is no common column between the department employees table and location tables. So we have to create join between employee table and department table. And then we have to create the join between the department table and now this query display the first name, last name and city. Let create the join between the three different tables. Now that if you want to display all of those employees whose city name is Oxford, that and I want to remove the city option over here, where city, L dot city is equal to what we have in single quotation marks, Oxford, close it. Now execute this one query, it will display these fetters, David fetters, these implies belong to the city Oxford. We create the giants among the three different tables using the natural giant clause. Now, in natural giant clause, we have one issue. The issue is that one, if we are having the more than one common columns, then it will display record based on those columns. Like in employee table and department table, we are having the two different common columns. In department table, department ID and manager ID. Employees table, we are having the columns are here, department ID and manager ID. So when we create the join among the department table and employee table, it creates the join based on these two columns. That's why it doesn't display all the record. Like select first name, last name, job ID and department name from employees E natural joint departments D. Now use column alias. If we are not using, that is okay. But that is a good approach to use it over here. E dot last name, E dot job ID, and D dot department name. Execute this one query. Now display first name, last name, job ID, and department ID. Let's see how many records are there. It displays just 32 different records. So when it displays the 32 different record, so remaining record where both of these department ID and manager ID values are not matched, then it does not display the record. So we are losing some information. That is one drawback in the natural join clause. To handle that one, we have to use the using clause. And using clause, what we have to mention the common column are the columns on the basis of which we have to create the joins. Like in department table and employee table, two common columns are there. Natural join clause automatically identify those common column and create the join. Now we have to use the using clause. We have to mention the column names on the basis of which column we have to create the joins. Let's select first name, last name, job ID, hire date, and then we are having the columns are here, department names, department ID, and department names. Now from employees E join departments D using, we have to use a using clause based on the which column we are create using. We have to use the department ID is the common column. On the basis of this one column, we have to create the joins. So using department ID. Now we have to use the table name E dot employee ID, E dot last names, E dot job ID, and then E dot hire date. Department ID again, here the column which is used in the using clause. Never use table name dot column name. If we use, it will display the error message D dot department ID. Now execute it. Now first name spelling mistakes are there. Execute it again. It displays first name, last name, job ID, hire date and department ID and department name. If we check now, it displayed over here 106 different record where department ID values are matched from employee table and department table. It display the record. So using clause, when we are using it, we have to mention the on the basis of which column we have to create the joins between the two different table. So for that one we have to use the using clause. Now same we can use it for the two table or three table or four tables. Now third one, another type of joins, that is on clause. That is also called the equijoins. In this one joins, whenever we are using the using clause, if we are having the two different table and their column names are not same, column name are different but containing the same data. That in employee table we are having the depth ID and department table we are having the department ID. That we are assuming the column name are the not same than two different table. When column names are not same than two different table but containing the same type of the data, then using clause can never work. In such cases, we have to use the on clause, or simply we say equijoin or inner joins. How we can use it? That we say select employee ID, first names, last names, department ID, department name from employees E. So whenever we say that join departments D, so for employee we have to use the E dot employee ID, E dot first names, E dot last name. Now here this one column is used, department ID will be used to create the join, but in on clause or equijoin we must have to mention this one column belong to which one table, that is belong to either department table or employee table. It E dot department ID. In previous two types of joins, it is necessary we don't need to mention the table name dot column name for the column that is used in join. But here the common column, with the common column we must have to mention the table name, otherwise it will display the ambiguity error that this one is an ambiguous column, and D dot department name. Now from employee join departments on, how we can create the join? We say that in employee table, the value of the department ID in employee table when matched with the value of the department ID in department table, then display the record. So what in employee table, we have for employee table we are using E, E dot department ID. When the value of the department ID of employee table is matched, that is equal to D dot department ID, then display the record. So this one is the equijoins. Now department ID is invalid. Just check it out. Yes, this one is spelling mistakes over here. This is fine. Okay. Now execute it. Department ID. E dot department ID is equal to D dot DEPART. Execute it. Yes. Now spelling mistakes are there. We use it. Now display employee ID, employee ID, first name, last name, department ID and department name. Now we create the join among the two different tables. Here we are having the column names are same. Still, but if we are having column names are the different, that I am changing column name using the alter statement. Alter table implies rename column, name of columns department ID to dep ID, and employee table I want to make the change department ID column to the dep ID. Now in employee table we don't have the department ID, we will have the dep ID. Copy this one, execute it. Now either department ID we don't have. If we use the data department, that is fine. Now instead of either department ID we have to use the depth ID. Whenever in employee table value of the depth ID is equal to the department ID and department table, then it will create the matching among the two different record. Now it displays the record, but if we are having natural join clause or using clause, it will never ever create the joins. Whenever we are having column names are the different but containing the same data. So this one is a equi-join. We can use it to create joins among the 2 table, 3 table, 4 table or other tables. N number of table can be used. Let we want to use it over 3 or 4 table. How? Select employee ID, comma first names, comma last names, then department name. Then we are having the city, this one is from the location table. Then we are having the country name, this one is from the country table, and then we are having the region names from employees e. So for that one employee we are using the e dot employee ID, e dot first names, e dot last names, and then we are having the for department we will use d dot department name. For location city is from the location table l dot city, country we have to use the c. For the country and the region we will use the r dot region names. Join departments. For department we have to use the alias d on e dot. For in e employee table we are having the columns in that one, e dot depth id is equal to d dot department id. D dot department id. Then again we have to create the join location l on l dot location id is equal to d dot location id. Join countries c on c dot country id is equal to l dot country id. Country is the count column between the location table and country table. Then join, that will we can create join between the country and region or on r dot region id is equal to c dot region id. This one will be we may be able to create join among the 5 different table, employee, department, locations. Okay, we see that table does not exist. Which one? Locations is here and we are using the location. Re-execute it, it creates the joins among the five different tables: employee, department, location, countries, and region. This one is a equi-joined. So in this one, if we are having the column names are same, then we may be able to create a join. Or even if we are not having the column names are same, then again still we may be able to create a join, but having the same type of the data. So these are the basic types of join: natural join clause, using clause, and on clause. Remaining types of join we will discuss in the next video. Thanks for watching the video.